Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
In this video, we are going to calculate the work done by a constant force acting in the direction of a linear displacement. Calculate the work done by a constant force making an angle with a linear displacement. Calculate the work done by a constant force along a curvilinear displacement. Explain the physical meaning of work. Calculate the work done by the weight of an object along any path. And solve an exercise about calculating the work done by different forces.
Let's explain the work done by a constant force in the direction of a linear displacement. Here is a wooden box attached to a ribbon. If we pull the box like this, the box moves under the action of the force exerted by the ribbon. The force exerted by the ribbon is in the direction of the displacement vector. How can we calculate the work in this case? We just multiply the magnitude of the force, which is F, by the magnitude of the displacement vector, which is D. In SI units, F is expressed in newtons, D in meters, and the work in joules. Now, let's study the work done by a constant force making an angle with a linear displacement. Observe. In this case, the force exerted by the ribbon is along this direction and the displacement vector is in this direction. There is an angle between the force and the displacement vector. Now, in order to calculate the work done by this force, we need to calculate the component of this force in the direction of the linear displacement, because this component is the one responsible for doing work. Now, consider this right-angled triangle. This is the angle alpha between the force and the displacement vector. This is the 90 degrees. The component of the force in the direction of the linear displacement is F cosine alpha. Then, in order to calculate the work, we just multiply F cosine alpha by D. D is the magnitude of the displacement vector. Then W equals F cosine alpha times D, or FD cosine alpha. But FD cosine alpha is the dot product of the force vector and the displacement vector. Let's discuss the work done by a constant force along a curvilinear displacement. Look at the figure. F is a constant force acting on an object moving on a curved path from A to B. AB, the green vector, is the displacement vector of the object between A and B. It can be easily shown that the work done by a constant force is independent of the path followed by the object. Then we can use the same formula obtained in the previous slide. The work of F is the dot product of the force and the displacement vector, which is equal to the magnitude of the force times the magnitude AB of the displacement vector times cosine the angle alpha between F and AB.
Now, let's distinguish between work in physics and our everyday understanding of the word. If you hold a heavy box for 5 minutes, as shown on the figure, you become tired and you think that you do work on the box. But in physics, a force would not do work if its point of application is not displaced. Therefore, even you become tired, you do no work. Now, let's discuss the physical meaning of work in physics. Work is a method of energy transfer. When work is done on an object, energy is transferred to the object if this work is positive, and energy is transferred from the object if this work is negative.
Let's discuss the two cases explained in the previous slide. Look at figure A. F is a constant force acting on an object while it is moving from A to B. AB is the displacement vector of the object. Alpha is the angle between F and AB. Alpha is an acute angle. Alpha is greater or equal 0 and it is less than pi over 2 radians. Now look at the expression. Cosine alpha is positive. Then the work done by this force is positive. This force helps the body during its motion. We say that this force is a motive force. In this case, energy is transferred to the object, which means that the object will gain an amount of energy which is equal to the work done. Let's move to the second case. Look at figure B. Now, the angle between F and AB is obtuse. Then, cosine alpha is negative. Therefore, the work done by this force is negative. We say that this force is a resistive force. In this case, energy is transferred from the object, which means that the object will lose an amount of energy which is equal to the work done.
Focus, please. This is important.
By referring to this formula, what are the conditions under which a force does not work? Let's study two cases. Consider the case where alpha equals pi over 2 radians, as shown in this animation. The angle between the force or the weight of the object and the displacement vector AB is alpha equals pi over 2 radians, but cosine pi over 2 radians equals 0. So in this case, the work done by F along the displacement AB equals 0. Hence, energy is neither transferred to nor transferred from the object. So we can conclude that a force perpendicular to the displacement of its point of application does not work. Now, consider the case where AB equals 0, as shown in this animation. An athlete holding a barbell. Since there is no displacement of the barbell, then AB equals 0. So the work done by each force exerted by the athlete on the barbell does no work. Hence, energy is neither transferred to nor transferred from the object. So we can conclude that a force does no work if its point of application is not displaced.
Now we are going to obtain a simple expression for the work done by the weight of an object. Look at this figure. An object moves from point A to point B on a curved path. HA is the initial height of the object relative to the ground, and HB is its final height. Now, to calculate the work done by the weight of the object during its motion from A to B, we use this expression, mg.ab. Now, look at the figure. AB is the displacement vector of the object between A and B. But AB equals AA prime plus A prime B. This is going to be mg.AA prime plus mg.A prime B. Now, again, look at the figure. MG is perpendicular to AA prime, then MG dot AA prime equals 0. Again, look at MG and A prime B. They have opposite directions. Then the dot product of MG and A prime B is the magnitude of the weight, which is MG, times the magnitude of A prime B, which is A prime B, times cosine 180 degrees. Now, A prime B equals the final height HB minus the initial height HA. Then Replace cosine 180 degrees by minus 1 and A prime B by HB minus HA. You will get this equation. This is going to be the work done by MG equals MG into HA minus HB. HA is the initial height of the object, while HB is the final height of the object. Now, we can use this simple equation to calculate the work done by the weight along any path. We just multiply the mass by the gravitational acceleration by H initial minus H final.
Now, let's study the consequence of this formula. M times G is always positive, but H initial minus H final could be negative, could be positive, and could be zero. During the upward motion, H initial is less than H final, so H initial minus H final is negative. Therefore, the work done by the weight is negative, and in this case, the weight is said to be a resistive force because it resists the upward motion. During a downward motion, H initial is greater than H final, so the work done by the weight is positive, and in this case, the weight is a motive force because it helps the downward motion. If the object moves horizontally, or if it changes its height but returns back to the initial horizontal level, in this case, H initial is equal to H final, so the work done by the weight equals zero.
Now, let's solve an application about the calculation of the work. A lorry pulls a log by means of a light rope, which makes an angle of 37 degrees with the horizontal. The tension in the rope has a magnitude of 1,200 newtons. The magnitude of the friction force acting on the log is 720 newtons. We neglect air resistance. Determine the work done by each force acting on the log as it is displaced a horizontal distance of 100 meters. Now, what are the external forces acting on the log during its motion from A to B? We have the weight MG, the normal force N, the friction force F, and the tension force T. Let's start with the normal force. The work done by the normal force equals the dot product of N and AB, but N is perpendicular to AB. The log moves horizontally and N is vertical. Then the angle between N and AB is 90 degrees. Therefore, the work done by N equals zero. Similarly, the work done by the weight of the log equals MG dot AB, and MG is perpendicular to AB and the angle between them is 90 degrees. Then the work done by MG as the log moves from A to B is zero. Actually, the work done by any force perpendicular to the direction of motion is zero.
Now, the work done by the friction is given by F dot AB, or the magnitude of the friction times the magnitude of the displacement vector AB times cosine the angle between F and AB. Look at the figure. The direction of the friction is opposite to the direction of the displacement vector AB, so the angle between F and AB equals 180 degrees. Now, replace F by 720 newtons, replace AB by 100 meters, and replace cosine 180 degree by minus 1. Therefore, the work done by the friction equals minus 72,000 joules. The work done by the tension equals T dot AB, or T times AB times cosine the angle between the tension and AB. Now, replace T by 1,200 newtons, replace AB by 100 meters and cosine 37 degrees by 0.8. Therefore, the work done by the tension equals 96,000 joules.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.